이때 이때 가운데
エオルゼアの南西、バイルブランド島。ロータの海に面するエミサ・ロミンサは、島南部のラノシア地方を擁する海洋都市国家である。湾内にある島々と岩礁の上に渡された橋楼が作る町並みは、女神の名を取り、リムレーンのベールと称されるほど美しい。海の都と謳われるこの都市に、今一人の冒険者が訪れようとしている。今はまだ己の運命を知らぬ者。神々に愛されし地、エオルゼアの歴史に名を残す者。この冒険者の長き旅は、海の都リムサ・ロミンサから始まる。
Just pull that out. Anyways, still start of the stream, still start of the game. Nothing missing. So hello peoples, we're just starting the game. Just getting through the tutorials and stuff like that. Getting started here. Hold on. Okay, so there's arrows that tell you where to go. Just another choice. press, you'll encounter objects that are not simply by approaching. Is this a trap? That's a family guy. Get a piece of candy. Get a piece of candy. Maybe it's just a box of spirit for me. Ooh, particular air. Ooh, particular air. Ooh, a particular air. There would be a clock. Oh, a particular air. Oh, a particular air. Put him on the floor for me. I am Akra. You have some herbs? Some quests will require you to get an item from the NPC requires item. Then item request window will appear, drag the items from your inventory on the quest into the item request and go and click and order to the item quest. Yes, as you suspected. These are highly illegal blooms known as dream flowers. They are a prime ingredient in the creation of zombies. The substance whose fragrance is said to lure the sniffer's mind into a certain death. Forgive me, I could not resist the gist. These herbs are not more than... How the fuck you say that word? Lavender, a common enough export ingredient. In fact, these probably spilled from the crates that were loaded onto the very own ship. I think someone has been having a bit of fun with you, son. But you don't have to worry, you'll learn a few things and made new acquaintances. Robin. Which is instant HP restoration and introduced boost. Using an item is simply as selecting use from items. Can I put this in? Put the little feathers. What is this doing? Excuse me, sir. But might you have a moment or two spare? You seem to take the type of joy being a custom, the many of us, and the power of someone to make a journey to the people sisters of the Edelweiss. I wouldn't be surprised if you hadn't heard of them. The sisters prefer not to advertise their presence here in the They do, however, provide a rather unique service, of which the Brugger Consortium has recently been beneficiary. I would have you deliver this package to the door, and lone word, along with a perfume guide. Alright, let's see how the quest system is. Not even so easy. Looks like someone just mashed their keys on this meeting. It's like, blip! By the way, thanks for delivering the scattered lavender. I have a nugget of information that may prove useful too. You see, I was recently approached by an unkempt seafarer, which is not, I admit, particularly unusual for a man in my profession. That what was unusual was that he offered a generous sum of deal to be introduced to any adventurers I might know. In my experience, those are not known to carry such a wealth of coin about their person, especially with the alehouses, omens of Lominza, so close at home. Kidnappings have not been uncommon this past month. I suggest you take care, keep the information, speak with Glazerail, the guard who stands attention. Their head is so fair, blah blah blah. Travel yet.
inside my own features. Interested in the surface level container. What's this? The suspicious seafarer is on the prowl of incredible adventures. A possible suspect in recent kidnappings, you think? Well, I'm sure to pass on the warnings to customers.
With all that, all the merchants and travelers milling through the valley, blah, blah, blah. In case, I promise to keep a sharp lookout for anyone being accosted by stranger visitors. A fine day to you, sir. Welcome to the most complete marketplace in Grand Realm of where every shelf groans under the weight of wonders born from all the four corners of the world. Pray browse the stalls until your eyeballs ache from ogling the overabundance of unbelievable bargains. Now, as much as I would love to elaborate upon the unrivaled quality of our merchandise, I must tend to some cargo that recently arrived at the docks. You bear a gift from Boudoir. Whatever could it? My octet. By the navigator I must have left it behind in the wrench, along with a week's pay and several bells worth in intoxicated memories. Steven's wrong. Drunk ass. I am most grateful to have it back. This tool is a keepsake from my days as a ship captain, you see. Needless to say, your good deed must be repaid. And what better recompense than the wisdom of a mathematician? If it is simple and sturdy adventuring equipment, you see, you need look no further than east and west arms of Hawker's Alley. Lest you doubt, each jill you invest in arms and armor will be mighty well spent. Adventuring is, after all, a dangerous profession by its very nature. Goes without saying that Hawker's Alley boasts stalls specializing in the tools of every martial discipline imaginable. And within but a few steps are bazaars and apothecaries. Almost apply amply, supply all your potion and perfume. Our keen-eyed agents procure a frankly befuddling range of wares during their sojourns. These distant stores start pace to become familiar with type of and price. Okay. So this knowledge will serve you well if your purse is light or your time is short. But verbal instruction of this kind will only profit you so much. Experience has ever been the surest teacher, if not the kindest. Explore the market yourself. Quest now. Look into your current market. Oh, I'm gonna pose, blah, blah, blah. On guard, you pesky rodent. Multiple solo players attack the same target. Player who attacks first will always receive 100% of its drop. Players who follow will be rewarded based on their contribution value. If you see a fellow player in need of a hand, do not hesitate to lend it. Thank you. poor thing. They don't do anything. I'd be like, I have to kill this. Item you have equipped is now balanced to you and can only be traded all equipment is there. The items can be sold and traded freely before the end of the battle captain gathering. This is true regardless of where you are. However, performing one of these three actions after equipping an item will bind item to going to the trader sale. Proceeds will purchase that item. Goodbye. I can kill this thing. Now it tells me. I click on the target to switch to active mode and ready auto attack or push this. Three rotating arrows will appear at the target. Actions such as spells and weapons, icons, and that far. These actions can be just initiated using the short button. Action points required. They need to kill those innocent lambs. There's much training to be done before you wield that axe. Force the principle. Learn well your lesson. Yeah, there's a punching ball out there. Next modder's quest will be... Fire. Thank you. fuck. At least in Guild Wars 2, it's much easier to get back to your quest, to clear it. But there's some, in Guild Wars 2, there's some quests that won't make you do that. It'll just, like, they'll let you complete it where you're standing. Be showing up before one ends. Please sense a fate nearby unless you go up there. No person will be spared next. Have the fate in progress can identify it. We identify it on its map. Back. Mousing over the entire way. Why not the giant fate the moment we cross the event? If you are several levels higher than the level, level sync will find the button if you're able to do this. Press the button, grab nothing. Lower your level so that you may press the space. I didn't just automatically just do it. Do what you do right now. His weapon will go all blunt. I'm gonna destroy his ass. That's the way to do it, Dad. I can do more. Okay, we're gonna end the stream. It's already been about two and a half hours. Sometimes I go long, sometimes I don't, but knowing that this game can take a long time, I kind of want to kind of get ahead of everything and get into kind of like the story. I think it's gonna be maybe a while till I get to do that, because once you get the story, you end up moving on. I think you end up like going to the next city once you complete things and stuff. So I want to be able to kind of complete everything in town. I should be almost done with it, but just getting around, it takes a long time. I'm surprised. I thought maybe getting around would be a little quicker, but I don't see anybody with a mount, and I don't know if you get mounts yet. I wouldn't mind getting one if they had it in the store, kind of like Guild Wars 2 in a way, but then again, who knows. Before I end it, I want to see what's over here. That was the nest. They wouldn't let me do anything. As if nobody's home. Mayhap they knew we were coming. Ed, I need Ed. Please, it's my grandsons. The snippers, I got them. I told Sighard not to get too close, and I told him to get himself in trouble. Get that ready weapon, or we need to move now. Yes, sir. Stupid. Good. Oh, it's back. It's dead, I know. You dumb little kid. It's gonna be 50. Shite! You say shit?
Get up in me, you bloody great bastard!
guess we're gonna have some seafood. I'll ask him, like, what would you like with the crab? Wait, do you like crab meat, by the way? Holy shit. A bad word. I can't even play outside no more with all these scary monsters, but they might admit that they both killed by some nasty buggers not so long ago. An aurox? Big as a mountain. But I bet you can beat it. I make it pay for what you just did to me. Take it easy now, son. There's a whole guild full of strapping lads and lasses like Aurora here who will be glad to teach us that. All you need to do is head home with your grandpa. You let us worry about that big nasty buggers. Consider your first duty success. It's time you headed back as well, before Woodzilla is gone. Begins to weigh up and left your cart for the pack. I gotta edit this video and try to make it a little shorter. It's almost like 3 hours. So, just all quests. That's all it is. Just all quests. And just running. Just standing there and just me just... just watching the running and just getting to the location. Get to the NPC. Complete the quest. Blah, blah, blah. Listen to what he has to say. And then just start running again. And it's like, oh... It's not bad. I mean, it's a good game to kind of just like, you know, if you're looking to kind of be casual, without any, you know, without any guilds kind of like, you know, having you do anything. I think that, if you're looking for something to kind of just chill and just, you know, try to get sleepy or whatever, this game could kind of do that. I'll try to stream a bit more. I was trying to do it like at least once per week, but I know I have to do it a lot more than that. Yeah, just swing on over to my my channel. Just I'll be putting out another probably like at least one or two videos. But I wanted to get all the quests finished, in the area, at least. And I think the next thing is just this right now. And then I have to go in there, and it takes you to another location. And then that's these right here, that's the check marks. I think that has to do with this location here. So that'll be the next thing. Alright, have a good morning, if it's daytime over there. Have a good night, and I'll see you in the next video. Please subscribe if you haven't, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for coming, thanks for joining my stream, and I hope to see you guys again the next stream. Alright, have a good night, and have a good morning. Bye-bye! Galaxy Cast's salute! Bye-bye.
Hi, Dylan. A vibrant planet blessed by the light of the crystal. Amid azure seas, encompassing the westernmost of the three great continents, there lies a realm embraced by gods and forged by heroes. Her name, Eorzea. The annals of Eorzean history chart the rise of a succession of great civilizations, each one enjoying an age of peace. The astral eras. To date, all have proven ephemeral. In the year 1572 of the sixth and most recent astral era, the Northern Empire of Gallimor amassed a great army at the heart of Eorzea, seeking dominion over all. Rising in desperate resistance, the forces of the Eorzean Alliance met their would-be conquerors in the field. Yet, even as the battle raged, the lesser moon, Gallimor, was plucked from the heavens through imperial machination. From its core emerged the elder primal Bahamut, who unleashed his fury upon the realm. The devastation brought Eorzea to its knees and the era to its end. Have come and gone. The light of life still shines upon Eorzea. Man labors tirelessly to raise himself from the calamity's ruin. The realm is forever changed, a stranger to him once more. Yet heedless of what lies ahead, he shall press on. Spurred by the promise of peace and prosperity. Amid this period of great change, an adventurer arrives in Eorzea, one whose tale is yet unwritten. May he ever walk in the light of the crystal.